The coronavirus outbreak is really hitting businesses hard now, so I thought it would be appropriate to do another video on what insurances could or may not respond to this virus. But let me start with the fact that every policy is different, and I'm speaking with a pretty broad brushstroke here based on the majority of what the insurance industry policy forms do look like, but I encourage you to speak to your agent or broker about your specific policies. I'd also like to say, don't get your hopes up, because most insurance policies are not written to include claims like these from a virus. So let's start with the financial impact to a business from the virus. Many people are thinking business interruption insurance. And in my first video, I indicated that business income or business interruption coverage was triggered when three things happen. The first is that there is direct physical damage to your location listed in the policy. Second, which is caused by a covered peril, such as a fire. And third, which causes a full or partial cessation of your business, causing you to lose income. In short, if you didn't suffer direct damage by a covered peril, there was no coverage. On top of this, most policies contain an exclusion for viruses and other diseases which may cause loss to property or income. A few weeks ago, most of the business income losses in the US were caused by supply chain interruptions. Materials or goods coming from China were delayed, causing companies here in the US to suffer loss of income. There was no coverage for those claims because the direct damage trigger had not occurred. Today we're seeing state and local governments closing businesses where people congregate, such as bars, restaurants, movie theaters, gyms, schools, and other places, which will likely be expanded to further slow the infection rate. Some may ask, does my policy cover something called civil authority? The answer is that most business policies do cover loss of business income caused by civil authority, but this coverage extension is limited. As I mentioned, business income coverage mandates the direct physical damage to your premises, which causes a full or partial shutdown of your business. The civil authority extension says that the insurance kicks in when a civil or government authority prohibits access to your premises due to the direct physical damage to a property other than your property, and that the other property was damaged by a covered peril. In most policy forms, the other premises must be no more than 1 mile from your covered premises. So once again, we're seeing the triggers revolve around physical damage to property, and the virus is not causing shutdowns due to physical damage. So to reiterate, just because a civil authority, such as a state or local government, is closing businesses due to COVID-19, I'm afraid there is no coverage in the business income or property insurance forms for it. Now, what about other common business policy forms in COVID-19? Let's start with workers' compensation. I've had some clients ask, what happens if an employee gets sick with coronavirus and it's found they caught it at work? Well, let's start with the fact that COVID-19 or coronavirus is really not any different than the common cold or seasonal flu when it comes to workers' compensation. For workers' comp to respond to disease claims, two conditions need to be met. The first is that the disease must arise out of and in the course of employment. And the issue must be peculiar in that the disease is found exclusively among or presents greater risk for certain employees. Outside of clients in the medical community, I think these are very hard bars to jump. Next, let's talk briefly about different liability forms. The general liability section of your business policy may cover claims which arise from customer illnesses. We're seeing this right now with cruise ship operators, but for many small and medium-sized businesses, this is probably not going to be a major cause of concern. Next, employment practice liability policies will likely respond to discrimination claims from employees or clients which allege discrimination from corona-related disputes. D&O liability? Well, we're starting to see shareholder litigation related to coronavirus and the impact of corporate communications, share price, and more. Look, it's really a fluid time with a lot of changes ahead. If you've got questions, we've got answers. If you need help with a risk strategy, insurance, or question in general, please let me know. We're here to help. Thanks.